In this video, we're going to cover section 7.3 titled Double Angle, Half Angle, and Product Sum Formulas. We're actually just going to go over two examples, so I'll have a double angle formula and a half angle formula example. Our first one here asks us to find sine of 2x, cosine of 2x, and tangent of 2x when cotangent of x is 3 over 5 and x is in quadrant 1. So the first thing you want to do is you want to look at this information and you want to write out what that means. Well, cotangent of x is equal to 3/5, which implies that tangent of x is equal to 5 over 3. Don't really need to write that down, but I usually find tangent of x easier to work with. What does that mean as far as the triangle goes? Then we have a right triangle here where we have angle x. Tangent is 5 over 3, so that means the opposite side is 5, the adjacent side is 3. And the hypotenuse we find by the Pythagorean theorem, right? So a squared plus b squared is c squared. A squared is 3 times 3, so 9. B squared is 5 times 5, so 25. 25 plus 9 is 34. And then, of course, we take the square root. So we want to continue on from there. We want to try to find sine of 2x, cosine of 2x, and tangent of 2x. Well, cosine of 2x and sine of 2x are all in terms of sine and cosine. So what are sine of x and cosine of x here? I'd like to point out that we know that x is in quadrant 1. That means cosine and sine are both positive. So if we write this out, we get sine of x is equal to opposite over hypotenuse, so that is 5 over the square root of 34. And cosine of x is equal to adjacent over hypotenuse, so 3 over the square root of 34. Okay. And we need to find sine of 2x. We have a formula for that, so we're just going to write down the formula. And that formula is 2 sine of x cosine of x, which is 2 times sine of x is, we just calculated that, 5 over the square root of 34. Cosine of x, we also calculated that, is 3 over the square root of 34. So this is 5 times 3 is 15. Square root of 34 times square root of 34 is 34, but then we also have a multiply by 2 up there, and this 34 is in the denominator, so 2 over 34 reduces to 1 over 17. So we get 15 sevenths for sine of 2x. We have cosine of 2x next. And this is cosine squared of x minus sine squared of x. Again, this is just a formula you'll find in the book and you should know. And so this is 3 over the square root of 34 squared minus 5 over the square root of 34 squared is equal to, right? So 3 squared is 9, square root of 34 squared is just 34, minus 25 over 34. This reduces to negative 16 over 34, which is negative 8 sevenths. And finally, tangent of 2x is just sine of 2x over cosine of 2x. That's not a formula that appears in this section. That's just the definition of tangent, right? Tangent is sine over cosine. We calculated sine of 2x in the first part and cosine of 2x in the second one. So this is, in fact, 15 sevenths over negative 8 sevenths. This reduces to negative 15 over 8. And that is it for problem number one. So we're going to move on and do problem two here, which says to use an appropriate half angle formula to find the exact value of sine of 13 pi over 12. We don't know the exact value of sine of 13 pi over 12 normally, right? We know exact values of sine of things like pi over 6, 0, pi over 4, pi over 3, pi over 2, and then et cetera around the unit circle. But in this particular case, using the half angle formula, we can actually find the sine of 13 pi over 12. So to do that, first off, let's write out a half-angle formula, and that is sine of u over 2 is equal to plus or minus the square root of 1 minus cosine of u all over 2. So to find sine of 13 pi over 12, we're going to use that formula. So I'm going to write out sine of 13 pi over 12 is the same as sine of 13 pi over 6 divided by 2, right? 13 pi over 6 divided by 2 is just the same as 13 pi over 12. So, in this formula up here, 13 pi over 6 is the u value. Except, 13 pi over 6 is the same as... Well, actually, we'll do that in a minute. So let's just rewrite this. So if 13 pi over 6 is u, this is the square root of 1 minus cosine of 13 pi over 6 all over 2. Now, notice that this had a plus or minus here, so we need to pick one, either plus or minus, but we have information to tell us which one that is. We don't just pick one randomly. So we're trying to find sine of 13 pi over 12. Well, 13 pi over 12 is in quadrant 3. So in quadrant 3, sine is negative. So this should be a negative square root of 1 minus cosine of 13 pi over 6 all over 2. And now here, cosine of 13 pi over 6 is the same as cosine of pi over 6, right? Because pi over 6 is the coterminal angle between 0 and 2 pi of 13 pi over 6. So this is, in fact, the same as 1 minus cosine of pi over 6, all divided by 2. So this is negative the square root of 1 minus cosine of pi over 6 is the square root of 3 over 2, all over 2. And that is our exact value for 13 pi over 12. And that's it for this section.